Welcome to the Capital Cube Classroom. How do you decide which stock to buy? How do you analyze the stocks already in your portfolio? In this episode, we'll take a fresh look at one of the most basic financial ratios for valuing a company. We are going to break this ratio down into its components and extract valuable insights about the company. Insights such as whether the company is outperforming its peers, if it is focusing on immediate results at the expense of long-term opportunities, if it is challenged in both operations and growth, or if the market expects a turnaround in the company's performance. First, let's take the example of Amy's lemonade stand to understand some key concepts and ratios. To set up her company, let's say that Amy needs $100. She finds this in two ways. She raises capital by borrowing $40, and she issues equity worth $60 at 60 cents per share. We refer to these numbers as the book value of debt and the book value of equity. Together, these numbers constitute the invested capital. In the case of Amy's lemonade stand, the invested capital is $100. Amy does a great job, and her lemonade stand takes off. In fact, it does so well that shares now trade at $3.60 per share. In other words, the market values the equity at $360. We call this the market cap. Because Amy has a good credit standing, the book value of debt is the same as the market value of debt. The enterprise value of a company is its market cap plus its market debt. The enterprise value of Amy's lemonade stand is 360 plus 40, which is $400. Remember that the invested capital was only $100. The difference between the enterprise value and the invested capital here is $300. This $300 can also be thought of as the value added by Amy to the initial capital. Market cap is $360. The price to book is 360 divided by 60, or 4. Why is the market valuing Amy's business at a premium? In fact, at 4 times its invested capital. Let's also look at other lemonade stand businesses in the market to see what premium the market is valuing them at. Is the premium for Amy's stand higher or lower compared to its peers? And if so, why? 1. Because of better or worse relative operating results. 2. Because of the market's expectations for growth. 3. Both factors. Maybe Amy has a secret recipe which lets her command a premium price, which is why her operating result is better than those of other lemonade stands. Or Amy may have successfully franchised her businesses in her state, and the market expects her to do this across the country. The answers to these questions are actually in the numbers. You just need to know how to interpret them. We will have to do a little math. Do bear with us. Price to book can be broken down into two components, return on equity and PE. Mathematically, our price to book valuation is the product of return on equity ROE and the price to earnings PE ratios. At Capital Cube, we refer to ROE as the operational advantage and the PE as the growth advantage. Breaking down the price to book into its components and plotting the company relative to its competition along these dimensions reveals the story about the company and its competition. Now that we understand the basic concepts, let's look at an actual stock, AstraZeneca. We can break the price to book numbers for AstraZeneca into its components, return on equity ROE and PE. Then we plot AstraZeneca and its competitors along these axes. The top right quadrant consists of companies with high operating advantage and high growth advantage. We classify these companies as outperforming. The top left quadrant consists of companies with high operating advantage but low growth advantage. We classify these companies as harvesting, that is, they are harvesting their existing clients but not expected to grow the business. The bottom left quadrant consists of companies with low operating advantage and low growth advantage. We classify these companies as challenged. That is, relative to their competitors, they are challenged operationally as well as struggling to grow their business. The bottom left quadrant consists of companies with low operating advantage but high growth advantage. We classify these companies as turnaround. That is, while the companies are not doing as well operationally, the market is valuing them highly and is expecting a turnaround. Looking at AstraZeneca and its competition, we can now see that AstraZeneca is a harvester, while Novo is an outperformer. The next logical question to ask is whether this is a one-off or a trend. We can review the trends over the last 5 years for AstraZeneca. Notice that the return on equity for AstraZeneca is exceedingly high relative to peers for a consistent period of time. But interestingly enough, on the price-to-earnings ratio, which tells us about expectations for growth, the company has lagged the competitive peer set for quite some time, and the gap is opening up over the last 2 years. Register at capitalcube.com and you can access this analysis on any company under the Fundamental Insights tab. If you'd like to follow Amy's success and continue to watch new lessons from the Capital Cube classroom, please bookmark our channel. We'd also love to connect with you on social media and hear what you think.